Hello. Hi. I'm Patricia McNeely. I'm an illumined Blu-ray twin flame from Chicago, Illinois. How are you? I really hope you're doing well. So first of all, I'd like to say thank you to everyone. Thanks for watching my videos. Thank you for participating in the webinars. The questions have been great. Also, thanks to everyone who has had a session or reading or a follow-up. The sessions have been on fire and very, very, very moving. And why? Because people are feeling again, and people are feeling the depth of this. How do they do that? Because you're in love. That's how. But sometimes the layers of the world, you know, they cover up and they get there, and you struggle to feel again, or things are said to you. So today what I want to talk to you about in this video is, this is a continuation of my last one where I mentioned high school sweethearts. Now I've had a number of people, especially lately, where you met early on. You met as children, you met in high school, you met in grade school, you met at college. And why would that be? Why, you know, why some of this? And this is a continuation of some of that explanation as to why, you know? Okay, so this is Twin Flames, Childhood and Atlantis Sweethearts. A lot of you are the children from Atlantis. Now, we did talk about the Children of Atlantis Transit several videos ago. I'll reference it in the description below. However, that being said, what is it about childhood sweethearts? What is it about the Atlantis sweethearts? And for that matter, the Lemurian sweethearts. What's it all about? Why do you feel? Why has it taken so long? Well, there's some pretty lengthy explanations, and there's lots of videos dedicated out there to what did happen or what could have possibly happened or what archaeologists uncover and so forth. However, I want you to be in the now moment about this. I want you to be present and right here, because this is the culmination of lifetimes of history. This is the physical reunification and remembrance of who you really are, why you're here to begin with. Why did you meet this person? Why did you somehow never feel like you could get deep into some other relationship, even when you tried? Even when you did your best or you tried counseling, and maybe you even thought like there was, you're thinking something is wrong with you, then maybe sometimes you started to think, I must have imagined that. Maybe I'm crazy. No, you're not crazy. You're not crazy. And that's a good thing, that you're not crazy, okay? Because you're going to stop doing some of the crazy things that we've done in karma. You just won't feel like it. But furthermore, you actually will continue moving along. So that transit that started, it's going to continue. For a lot of you, it's going to continue in cycles of about every 10 days. And it will follow the lunar cycles for the most part. So half moon, full moon, new moon, half moon, you know, like new moon, full moon. Some of you are going to be doing this at the quarter moons, quarter moon, every quarter, half, third quarter, full moon, new moon. Okay, so everyone has a past. You're being allowed to let it go and fully detach. The old paradigm started closing in January of this year. And I encourage you, continue to gather you yourself in. And here's a big thing. How would you like to take your twin flame off the market? You've been off the market. Some of you have been off the market and you're considering putting yourself back on the market because you're just not sure what to do. Don't do it. Don't do something that is the definition of insanity. Doing the same thing, expecting the results to be different, and they won't be different. The one thing about karma is it's going to get weirder and weirder and strange. okay? You try to delve into it, it's going to be very short-lived for you. You can go backwards if you want to. I don't encourage it. It gets weird. It gets sometimes painful, and then you still have to disentangle yourself. Why bother? You're better off holding steady. Please hold steady for at least another month here. I can say that in a general way. There's a huge event that everyone's been sensing is coming, and some of you are like a stalled out vehicle. Like you're like a vehicle that's going, and you're trying to get over certain humps. You're going to be able to. How you do it is you let it go. Why? Because those strings keep trying to pull you back. It's like that line in The Godfather. Every time I try to get out, they pull me back in. Don't let it. Don't let yourself. Don't engage. Don't indulge. Don't do the drama. Don't look at it. Don't see it. Try to forget it. But easier said than done. Why? People tell you let it go. A lot of people are being told let go of your twin. You don't let go of the twin. You don't. I'm going to say that one more time. You do not let go of your twin. Now, what do you do if they've pretty much told you off? Because I covered that. I told you, in fact, I titled one of my videos, The Big Kiss Off. You got the big kiss off from 3D. That old paradigm kissed you off, told you goodbye, told you to get out, told you, you know, don't let the door slam you in the butt. And you were upset and you were hurting, okay? I don't want to see anyone get hurt, but some of this stuff hurts. Why? Because the calluses are gone, the hardnesses are gone. You have healed. You're alive again. You can feel, you can sense. But you don't like some of the things you're sensing. And nor should you. So how do you take you and your twin off the karma market? It does involve making a decision that you're not going backwards. No matter what kind of delicious, good-looking soulmate starts to pop up in front of you. Because why? Number one, that person's going to be digging on your flaming energy that emanates from your heart if you met your twin. Number two, you're still going to have to clean up the karma, okay? Meaning you will still have to clear your sacral area. You still will have to clear out your emotional area and your head and your eyes from them. How do you do that? So this involves bringing in your spirit, subtle body, clearing your shared psyche while cleansing the cells of your body. So for a lot of you, you are going through this deep cellular cleansing. You're feeling the changeover, and even science has alluded to every 7 years you slough off old cells and you get things out. Well, this is a culmination of a cycle that has started for some of you 8,000 years ago, 11,000 years ago, 20,000 years ago, 26,000 years ago here on Earth. What are you getting rid of? The bad emotions, bad memories, rather, are getting archived, and the emotions are floating to the top to get the lower emotions up and out. And a lot of you are feeling this. You're feeling things, and you're feeling as though you're sad, you're grieving, the grief has come out, the mourning, the losing people, the having to pick up and go and leave your country or leave your land, or you had a drought or you were flooded out. There are things you may not remember what happened to you. You may have had to leave a favorite planet and come here. This has been the place to come. Atlantis was my home. I was a healer there. And some people might say, woo-woo, I'm a little bit tired of the fluffy stuff, you know, living in La La Land and fluffy stuff. Well, let me do say this, that living as an ascended being in Atlantis was extremely different than living in a 3D existence here in a dense body. Some people have memories of it, some people don't. Many people who do remember were the children. The children of Atlantis. And yes, you were together with your twin. And yes, things kind of took a turn. That's not what I'm here to dwell on. So bring you all forward what's been happening. Well, many of you have been aware that sometimes your twin has felt like the Matrix person, okay? And they're under that glass ceiling, okay? And they can't seem to get out of it. However, what you haven't been aware of is if you are the feminine, 90% of you have been on the 4D shelf, okay? Now your twin is coming out from under this. You're both coming out from your glass ceiling. What's the glass ceiling been? It's been things that were taught to you, ancient rituals, ancient memories. It's going to be religious stuff that no longer applies and doesn't feel like anything to you. Why? Because now it's in the people. That sounds like maybe a platitude, but how many people have been feeling things? Some of you have had to go to ancient sites. Sometimes what you're actually doing at those ancient sites is a bit of spiritual house cleaning. So you have the person who's in 4D, and many times they were a little bit awake with more of their chakras open early on as a child. They saw angels. She's been able to see angels, see shadows, communicate with animals, see colors. She's seen some things beyond the veil. She's been able to tell things. Not everyone has wanted to hear it because not everyone has that open. Some people are asleep. Some people are afraid. And she's learned to navigate this and learned how to cope with things. It hasn't been easy for her. It really hasn't. Now she's here. She's pretty adept at it. She's got this. Why? Because everything has continued on an ascension trajectory. Her twin has continued on the ascension trajectory until they're ready to meet again. Now, why, if you meet someone early on, what happens? Okay, if these two meet as children, what has happened? Well, connections to the subtle bodies have connected. Okay, there's like a key connection point of the emotional body and the heart, but it's like a little tick. Okay, these two have been clicked together. They decide to part ways, or it gets intense, or she wants to get serious and get married right away. He doesn't, or he. I have actually had a lot of people say that the male counterpart has wanted some things right away and she hasn't. But why? Why? Because you've needed to finish your old paradigm stuff, but now it's time to stop spinning with it. The old paradigm is gone. You're able to close the door, and there's a lot more to it than bad memories. It's going to be bad ancestry. The bitter roots of disappointment that you've had when you've had things taken from you, or been forced out, or conflicts. There's going to be disease. Diseases not just caused by catching something from someone. There's been disease caused by neglect or poor nutrition. And it's been passed down. I mean, I even saw in a film, like I had this reminder, it was Oliver Twist. Thank you, Charles Dickens, for exposing some of this stuff about, you know, what children had. And there's the ringleader of the thieves. His name's Fagin, and he's frying up these sausages. And one of the little boys says, "This sausage is moldy." And Fagin says, "Eat it anyway." And that's what people did. They ate spoiled food. Why? Because there was nothing else to eat. But that would make people addled. It would affect their nervous system. It would affect their ocular system. There have been things that have been unintentional harms. And what is it about the old paradigm that you're able to do? Good news here. Close it out. We just had our Independence Day here in the United States. You just had yours in France. Happy Independence. But what does that independence mean? That means you and your twin are now able to be emotionally liberated, mentally liberated, and free. You no longer need to be a victim to the old paradigm. Okay, and a lot of people like to, you know, swim in that. They're just like some people like to listen to country music and say, oh, woe is me. My lover left me and I'm here with the kids. And you'll stay in that victim mode until you decide to get out of it. But the good news is what? That things have been freed up. You're in a much more liberating energy now. There are others that have gone before you to have their own little revolutions and pave the way on this. Okay, so what does that mean? It means if there's a divorce, there's some legislation in place. If there are things to do, and you might say, I'm in a culture where it doesn't. It has to start where it began. It doesn't just start with talking to people. It has to start with spirit, with your spirit body. You have to bring in your spirit and clear out your cells, the cellular memory, and get yourself free. Now, you could have another couple, okay? And you can have another couple like this, where you have one and he keeps trying to get through to her, but she can't perceive. She just can't perceive. And he keeps trying to let her know, I'm here, I'm here, I'm here. And she's saying, where is he? I can't feel him anymore. I cannot feel him. Why doesn't he call? Why doesn't he do something? Do something. He's the man. He's supposed to come forward. I'm a woman. I'm not supposed to do this. I don't know. And you see, you have a couple where, once again, they've been positioned in a certain way. There are two things that are incumbent on every twin flame couple, whether you live together or you're physically in a separation. That is heart communication, because the body is new. That's going to be voice, throat, in this area. A lot of you are having chest constrictions. Why? Because you're getting squeezed like a tube of toothpaste to get everything out from the old paradigm. The pressure is on. You're under pressure, or your twin is under pressure. You have to help each other. So I had another little sign. I went over to my mother's house, and we were looking through some. She had dug out a suitcase. This is one of those hard travel cases. She had it full of the photos from one side of the family. So this was a little bit of my ancient Lemurian lineage that was getting cleared. So this was the Swedish side. So the Scandinavian countries have a very strong connection to Lemuria. You've been some of the very first angelics that came here from Sirius. And what did I find in there? In all these photos, so look what we got here. My grandfather was in the Navy, in the United States Navy. He sent all these postcards. So there's military stuff that has been in the family. This is World War II era. He wrote to his family. And there's my grandmother with my dad as a little boy. And this is my Swedish grandmother, looking very Swedish there, I think. And this is circa about, you know, somewhere in the 40s, 1940s. But interestingly, there were two other things in there. So some of you like cards. In Chicago, cards come to you. Okay, I'm just teasing about that. But the Ten of Swords. Now, what is the Ten of Swords? If you look this up, this is actually the old school masculine death. You know, the picture of this is actually a male figure face down, bleeding out, covered from the waist down, with 10 swords stuck in the back. Been backstabbed, been hurt, been harmed, been... And there's a sword in the hand, too, except They're dead. They're almost dead in the water. Why? Because that's the old paradigm. We're going to fight and fight and fight, but now it has died out. Now, interestingly, what was also in there was Santa Claus. That's my dad, and there's Santa. Now, of course, Santa, being Santa, Santa brings magical things. So this is some of the magic of bringing the lovers, the true lovers, back from the time of Atlantis and bringing you together for your reunification. Now, the reunification doesn't happen without any effort on your part. You have to participate. You have to be able to catch your spirit body, your other subtle bodies, and cleanse yourself, cleanse your cells. And how you're going to get through this, I made it easy for you. I have a webinar called Catching Your Spirit Body. This is particularly important for people who have twins that have been drinking, drugging. It's run in my family on this side as well. My grandmother didn't, but the other relatives in the family did. Grandpa the sailor, who was in the Navy, he did. It finally did him in. And so that runs in the family. Also, sealing the gates of the heart. You have to know how to seal, because it does you no good to push the old paradigm out if you haven't closed the door and sealed things up. If you're cracking people off, if you're going through heartaches and mourning and chest pain and belly aches and headaches, and your body is having inflammations, you also want to be able to seal yourself up. Now, this is a principle that actually has been in several traditions, where you seal yourself for a year, or you do your inventory, you cleanse things out, and you're set. There's no difference, except when it comes to your subtle bodies, there is a way to do that. And so I have that information. There are activations and light codes in all of my webinars. Also, my series on the subtle body, the subtle body series, which are the primers. I talk about sleeping because many of you have changed your sleep patterns. Your breathing needs to be new. There's a difference between angelic breathing and human mode breathing. If you're in angelic mode, you're doing one thing. If you're in human mode, you're doing something. And many of you are feeling that distinct difference. Why? Because you lived as ascended angelics in Atlantis. You're Atlantis sweethearts, or you're Lemurian sweethearts. You are some of the first ones in this wave of 1.5 million couples coming into union with each other. Full physical union. And these are available. Also, your causal body, which is how you create your stuff that you need, want, desire, and also for your family, including things having to do with healing. So you're intending to be self-regenerating, self-healing, everything. Sovereign beings. So check it out. It'll be in the description below. It is on my website. I've made some changes to my website. Check it out. www.twinflamesmerge.com. So once again, thank you for listening. Please subscribe. Good things happen when you subscribe. So thank you so much. Have a wonderful weekend and have a great week. Bye now.